This tutorial shows how to insert built-in and custom watermarks on specific pages in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. Today we're going to look at how to insert a built-in watermark on a specific page in Microsoft Word. Then we'll look at how to insert a custom watermark on a specific page. This is the third part of a three-part series about watermarks in Word. The first part shows how to insert text watermarks, and the second part shows how to insert image watermarks. The steps shown in today's tutorial can be used for both text and image watermarks. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to Word 2019, Word 2016, and Word 2013. These steps don't apply to Word for Mac. To insert a built-in watermark on a specific page, first place your cursor in the page to which you want to add the watermark. Then select the Design tab in the ribbon. Next, select Watermark in the Page Background group. Now, right-click the design you want in the drop-down menu and select Insert at Current Document Position from the shortcut menu. The built-in watermark should now appear only on the page where you inserted your cursor. When I switch to read mode for easier viewing, you can see that my watermark is on the first page, but not on the second page. This section includes the basic steps for creating a custom text watermark. The steps to insert the custom watermark on a specific page also apply to a custom image watermark. To begin, select the Design tab in the ribbon. Then select Watermark in the Page Background group. Next, select Custom Watermark from the drop-down menu. When the Printed Watermark dialog box appears, you can create and customize your watermark. I'm going to create a custom text watermark that says Top Secret and change the font color to red. When you're finished, select the OK button. Your custom watermark should be inserted into your whole document or current section. But don't worry, we'll remove it soon. Next, double-click the top of the page to open the Header and Footer tab. With the Header and Footer tab open, click the watermark to select it. Small resizing handles will appear around the watermark when it's selected. Now, select the Design tab in the ribbon, followed by Watermark. And then select Save Selection to Watermark Gallery in the drop-down menu. Type a name for your custom watermark in the Create New Building Block dialog box, and then select the OK button. Next, reselect Watermark. This time, select Remove Watermark from the drop-down menu. The watermark should be removed from the whole document. Now, double-click inside the page where you want to insert the custom watermark. Note that double-clicking inside the page will close the Header and Footer tab. Once again, select Watermark, and then locate and right-click your custom watermark in the drop-down menu, and select Insert at Current Document Position from the shortcut menu. Your custom watermark should now appear only on your chosen page. After you save your document as you normally would, an alert box will ask if you want to save changes to the building blocks file. This change is the custom watermark you added to the watermark gallery. Select Save if you want to reuse your custom watermark on other documents. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to create a cover page in Microsoft Word, and how to change page orientation in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erinwrightwriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic about Microsoft Word or Adobe Acrobat that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.